Francis turbine tutorial question number 1. A Francis turbine works with flow rate of 15,500 liters per second and runner rotates at 428 rpm. Velocity of water at inlet is 9 meters per second and pressure head at this area is 260 meters of water. Center point of turbine is located at 3.35 meters from the draft tube. Inlet diameter and inlet width of runner is 2.4 meters and 0.3 meter respectively. If overall efficiency is 90%, determine the power of turbine, the guide vane angle, and the blade angle at inlet. To answer this question, first you need to draw the velocity triangle. So this is the velocity triangle for the question. Normally, in Francis turbine, the blade is backward. It is because for this shape, it is easy for this blade to receive water from here. And then this shape will receive a lot of amount of energy transfer from water, and it easily to move or rotate at this direction. So if this shape is backward, so we have velocity triangle like this. First, you need to draw the actual velocity V1, and then you need to draw the actual or the absolute velocity V2 here. Then at inlet point number 1 here, we draw U1 and continue with VR1. And then we also could draw V1 here and VF1 like this. At outlet here, we could draw VR2 like this and V2 like this. Normally, we could assume that whirl velocity at outlet is equal to 0. Next, we need to list all the parameters that we get from the question. We have B1 equals 0.3, D1 equals 2.4 meter, V1 equals 9 meter per second. We have a pressure head P over rho G 260 meters. We have overall efficiency 90%. We have flow rate 15,500 liter per second. And we have RPM, which is 428 RPM here. Then we need to calculate the power of turbine. First, you need to draw the Francis turbine structure like this. We have a tank here, and for sure this tank has its own water level, and then this tank is connected with a pipe system like this and then go through inside Francis turbine, and then water will release at the bottom here to another reservoir here. From the question, we know that the distance from the Francis turbine to the draft tube is 3.3 meters. And then if we have diagram like this, we could say that normally we could point this level is point number 1. And then we point the center point of Francis turbine as point number 2. And the water level at the outlet here is point number 3. From the question, we know that the distance from 2 to 3 is 3.35 meters. However, we do not know what is the distance between point number 2, the center of Francis turbine, to the water level here. To calculate the power of the turbine, we will use this equation. P for power is equal rho GQ H effective. And then from this diagram, we could also write a Bernoulli equation. Because we know the distance from 2 to 3, it is wise for us to write Bernoulli equation comparing energy at point number 2 and point number 3. So we have Bernoulli equation P over rho g plus v square over 2g and z. We substitute all the value here. We could say that pressure at point number 3 is equal to 0 because it is an atmospheric pressure. The velocity at 2, the velocity at 3 here is equal to 0, and the level at point number 3 is equal to 0. So in the right term here, we only have the head of turbine. Then we could rearrange this equation, become like this. Then we could substitute the value from the question. The pressure head is 260 meters. The velocity V2 is 9 meters per second. And the value of Z2 here is equal to 3.35 meters. So we could calculate the value of head of turbine here is equal to 267.5 meters. After this, we could calculate the power of turbine by using this equation, and then we substitute all the value here, and then we get it is around 40.67 megawatts. Please be careful. For flow rate here, we are using meter cube per second. So we need to change 15,500 liter per second to 15.5 meter cube per second. Next, we need to calculate the guide vane angle. The guide vane angle is the angle at this position because the angle of absolute velocity V1 here is actually parallel with the guide vane because the guide vane was located here. This guide vane is to make sure that the absolute velocity will flow at a certain angle. So means that the angle of V1 here is the angle of the guide vane. From this velocity triangle, we could say that sine theta here is equal to VF1 divided by V1 here. So we substitute the value here, we could get the angle theta here is equal 49.6 degree. Now we are calculating the blend angle at inlet. From this velocity triangle, we could say that the blend angle at inlet is located here. And then from this velocity triangle, we could say the tangent of beta 1 here is VF1 over V1 minus U1. So the equation is shown here. So to get the value of U1, to substitute in this equation, we could calculate U1 by using pi dn over 60. And then we could get it is equal to 53.8 meter per second. Then we could calculate the velocity of whirl 1 here by using this equation. And we have advantage here because the tangent for theta is already calculated. It is equal to 49.6. We could use this equation to calculate V1 here, and it is equal to 5.83 meter per second. Then we substitute the value of VF1, V1, and U1 in the equation. We could get beta 1 is 8.13 degrees.